Good evening, student. Today, our discussion topic is Microsoft Excel, page number 57. Children, nowadays the business is dependent on financial analysis, which requires fast and accurate business decisions and planning strategies. Information system needs to integrate and analyze large volumes of data from several sources. Analysis of data involves statistical and mathematical calculations. Present data in graph form of facilitate comparison between two sets of data and relating tables of data from more than one source. Spreadsheet packages have been developed, which allow you to perform analysis on numerical data. Spreadsheets are also known as worksheet, in which data is displayed in the form of rows and columns. Data is entered in a cell, which is intersection of row and column. Formulas can also be entered in a cell that will contain the result of calculation. So, Microsoft Excel is a good spreadsheet program that helps in calculation using formula and analysis of data using tables. I repeat again, Microsoft Excel is a spreadsheet software that helps in calculation using formula and analysis of data using tables. It is a part of the Microsoft Office package. It includes all the features of spreadsheet package like automatic calculations, functions, and graphs, etc. Now, how to start MS Excel program? To start MS Excel program, first select then all programs option, then click on Microsoft Office, and after that Microsoft Office Excel 2007. This opens the MS Excel window, which is a blank worksheet. I repeat again, to start MS Excel, first select Start button, then all programs option, then Microsoft Office, then Microsoft Office Excel 2007. This steps opens the MS Excel window, which is a blank worksheet. Now, properties of worksheets or components of MS Excel window. The components of MS Excel's window are: number 1, rows, columns, cell, cell pointer, active cell, sheet tab, active sheet, etc. Now, workbook. An MS Excel document is called workbook. Worksheet. Each workbook contains multiple pages called worksheet. The active worksheet, that the worksheet is used, is the one displayed in the document window. Now, cell. A cell is the smallest unit of a worksheet. formed by the intersections of rows and columns. A cell is the smallest unit of a worksheet formed by the intersection of rows and columns. Each cell has a unique address formed by the combination of a column letter and a row number. For example, where row 4 is intersected by the column D, the cell is formed as the D4. I repeat again. Each cell has a unique address formed by the combination of a column letter and a row number. For example, where row 4 is intersected by the column D, the cell is formed as the address D4. Now, cell pointer. A cell pointer is a highlighted cell boundary that specifies which cell is active at that moment. So, workbook, worksheet, cell, rows, columns, cell pointer, these are the properties of a worksheet. Now, saving. Before save the worksheets, we have to learn how to entering data in a worksheet. Data is entered simply by selecting a cell, typing in it, and then pressing the enter key. As you type, the data fill the formula bar and the active cell at the same time. The formula bar is located above the work area of the worksheet and displays the data or formula stored in the active cell. It can be used to enter or edit data or formula in a cell. To move the next cell, press the tab key. To move to the adjacent cells, press the required arrow on the keyboard. The two small buttons appear to the left of the formula bar as soon as you start typing in a cell. One is the cross symbol and other has a tick symbol. The cross symbol is called the cancel button and can be used to cancel the data entry without needing to press the delete key. I repeat again, the cross button is called the cancel button and can be used to cancel the data entry without needing to press the delete key. The tick button is called the enter button. Click this button is equivalent to press the enter key. There's one important matter is what MS Excel does not accept your data until MS Excel does not accept your data entry until you press the enter key or click the tick button. After entering any data in your worksheet, you can save it. And you can enter the three types of data in MS Excel worksheet. This number, text or formula. Three types of data can be entered in MS Excel worksheet. One is number, text and formula. Now come how to saving a worksheet. If you want to save your data in your worksheet, select the Save option from the File menu. Okay. Number two, if you are saving your data for the first time, the Save As dialog box appears. Number three, in the Save In list, select the drive and the folder where you want to save the worksheet. Number four, in the File Name box, type the required name for your workbook. And after that, click the Save button. I repeat the steps to saving a workbook again. First, select the file from select the Save option from the File menu. Then the Save As dialog box appears. Next, in the Save In list, select the drive and the folder where you want to save the workbook. In the File Name box, type the required name for your worksheet. And next, click the Save button. After that, your documents will be saved in the computer memory permanently. Now, how to open a workbook? If you want to open your workbook, first click on Microsoft Office button. Click on Open option. The Open dialog box will appear on the screen. In this dialog box, select the file which you want to open. Now, click on Open button. Now, you will see that your file will be displayed on the screen. Now, editing. Children, before edit in a worksheet, we have to learn how to selecting worksheet cell. It is very important for you. Children, before performing any operation in Excel, for example, typing data into cell, coloring cells or deleting them, you need to choose cell on which you are going to perform the action. This process is called cell selection and it is the fundamental Excel skill. You can select a single cell, a block of cells, a horizontal rows or a vertical columns or several rows or columns at the same time. You can also select several groups of cell. When a group of cell is selected, they will appear in black, except for one cell, the active cell, which remains white. To select a single cell, move the mouse pointer over your chosen cell and click. The thick black border that appear on the cell, which indicates that the cell is selected and it is now the active cell. Selecting a block of cells. Block of cells or group of cells. A block can range from a few adjacent cells in a single row or column to a large rectangular area. To select a block of cells, click on a cell at one end of the block you wish to select. Hold down shift key and then click on the cell at the opposite end of the block. Selecting a single column. To select a single column, just click on column header button at the top of your chosen column. In this way, you can select a single row. To select a single row, click on row header button to the left of your chosen row. This row will then be highlighted. Now, selecting rows or columns. While holding down the left mouse button, drag the mouse pointer across the header buttons for the column or rows you wish to include and then release the button. Selecting several blocks. Select the first cell or block, hold down Control key. Select the next cell or block, then select a third or block and so on. Now release the Control key. Now selecting the whole worksheet. To select the whole worksheet, click on the top left corner of the border of the worksheet. This is called Select All button. The whole of the worksheet will now be highlighted and the top left cell is the active cell. If you apply the shortcut method to select a entire worksheet, press Ctrl A. To select the whole worksheet, just select, press Ctrl plus A key on the keyboard. Children, do you know how many rows and columns are there in your worksheet? In the latest versions, there are 1,48,576 rows and 16,384 columns in a worksheet. I repeat again, according to the latest versions of the MS Excel 2007, there are 1,48,576 rows and 16,384 columns in a worksheet. So children, I am coming again to with the remaining parts of this chapter. Till then, goodbye. You listen this audio very carefully. And if you have the computer at home, please try these steps in your computer. Then you will understood better. Till then.